I'm playing Gaia Project against the Automa. I took a little bit about did some setup, and I decided to play as Terrans against the Ombas. No, not the Ombas, the Taklons, but it doesn't matter. I wasn't really sure which faction to pick here. Generally, this board state is blue's pretty good on it, red's pretty good. I thought Xenos might be pretty good. I didn't necessarily have to pick Terrans, but I decided for some reason to make play against brown. It was convenient, it was already up. If I wanted to optimize better, I might have decided that I was going to play red or yellow and picked a faction to suit. Perhaps white with yellow or red. I don't know. Terrans are generally a strong faction. In this game we have Gaia Planets later, and then also Techs. We need to build our stronghold early. That's something that we will want to do as Terrans relatively quickly. And these are some inconveniently located bonus tiles. This is good, this is good. The victory points for placing on Gaia and the money income, but we want this at some point for certain. We almost always want this tile, and this is not exactly the ideal spot for it. We want to be building buildings and different planet types. Terrans doesn't have any particular bonus against for doing some of those things, so we might get beaten by the objectives here. I slotted in the Ultoma, Automa rules, so it has the extra cards, two extra cards, 15 and 9, and shuffle these yet. And the bonus tiles, the Automa picked this bonus tile. We got range, we got the 4 power, we got one worker and one ore, and we got the temples with knowledge. One ore and one knowledge. And temples and knowledge. I'm gonna pick the only one that seems really well. Worker is always good. You could reasonably pick this one, assuming that you're gonna get a lot of power to charge. Which likely you will. I'm gonna go ahead and try and charge this power quickly, and then build up into a Gaia Former. I have a couple of spots to place Skyformers right off the bat. So we're going to charge all this power. Hey Jackson, cool it down please. So, let's get started. Let's also hope he feeds me power. He's going to build and take one of these actions. Actually takes is kind of significant. He's going to score 2 points. And he's going to build the shortest distance. Tiebreaker is the faction tiebreaker, but he prefers under normal circumstances. So he's a 3 range, and he wants to build. I don't even remember. First he wants to build on something that's convenient for him, then he wants to build closest to me. Planet requires fearing terraforming steps. One terraforming step here, and he's next to yellow and what? And gray. This is also one step. This is one step. So I think that these are agnostic. What's this? What's going going on here? Oh, this is where he can build. He can't get to here. He can get to here or here. And they're both in range. It's this direction, so it's this one. Probably want to build here during this turn. Jackson, cool down, please. Is your food ready? Are you eating it? Okay, just sit down at the table, please. Now I gotta figure out what to do. I think I like going up the knowledge track with this. I absolutely want to get this tile. We are going to be Gaia farming throughout the whole game. Can we afford to get this tile and go up something like this? We're gonna have we're not gonna have any gold income to speak of. This way, so it upgrades this. Okay, Jackson, go brush your teeth, please. You're being totally crazy. I want him to give me more power. It's not necessarily something he's going to do, but... Well, there's a danger he could take this action. That's not. There you go. go up again. If I take this tile, I could be able to get there with ease. he passes. Bad luck again. Establish this Gaia former. Let's do it right there. Sure. I don't think it matters that much. And I think I probably want to build a trading post. Don't have to do this. Free money or worker for now. Probably more valuable that I just keep the worker income. Any other benefit? This. We didn't get to this turn, but I'm definitely planning on building a PI next turn. It'd be nice to have a trading post already set up for this. We need to have, oh, I only need to have six of this total, which I'll have. Oh, I didn't pass fix the first one. That's fine. I probably want to take the worker. No. Okay. Knowledge. Getting that knowledge spammed out quickly. And more of these and more of these from where I was at last turn. So nothing fancy on the first turn here. Just a pretty standard spam a temple, spam a another mine, and the Terran thing where we spam a Gaia former. Tempting maybe to spam an academy on the first turn since we had the bonus to do it, but I want to get the PI as Terrans It's a very, very powerful PI. That's where the stupid thing was. Can't zoom out while I'm holding it, apparently. And it so happens that he passed first. Points. That's unfortunate for him. This is an awful setup in terms of the amount of points he's going to be able to get from these. To upgrade. The first thing he wants to upgrade to is this. That's two for one. So that gives us 5 points. We have to generate some money in order to at least build here. So he has to give us more power. That's what that means. It's 1 point for that. Probably not. We always seem to get this card. 3 more points, and 2 from the left. Now I can get 3 more power here, which is probably the way that I'm gonna to find this power. It's a useful track to go up. In any case, although I would like to go up here. These tech tiles. Oh, that's a tech tile I'd like. He might beat me to it. Random this track. Automa. Automa reasons. That's a good tech. That's a good tile, too. And this may be a good tile, too. Took this thing, but not the money. upgrades. This doesn't exist yet, so this is the one where he's going to build. This is 3 for 2, which I'm actually not taking because of the unfortunate timing, because I'm going to use this Gaia Former. Something which I may do now, because I have nothing else. Oh shit, that's not what I'm doing. This is what I'm doing, obviously, first. He doesn't pass, he builds. If he builds, I'm declining the power from it. Range 4. So this is the fewest terraforming steps, and this is closest to me. Well, okay, so the power, this is meaningless because the power would have come back here anyway. So that free power is lost. And then we get to play the Skyreformer there. And he doesn't pass, he takes this thing. 4 from the right, that's this. Not that this matters in any way. 2 from this. That's the last thing. The last action, and he's going to build another mine with range 3. Faction tiebreaker is the most important thing here. Also, maybe I didn't do this right, but whatever. The shortest distance to my planet. It's the only factor, it doesn't matter what kind of terrain it is. It's bad. But whatever. This time is 2 for 1, in a way that I can actually take. These are unfortunate. I want this one. What am I actually doing? I guess I'm gonna take this. Pick this. The tiles kind of suck. He still doesn't pass. He goes up a random track, it's 2 to the right. That's all his cards, so now he passes. He gets, again, no points from this. Come on, pick up the whole deck. Shuffle twice, because that's just how we roll. Okay. Oh, fuck. Alright, I'm retconning this. That was dumb. That was just dumb. Brain dead dumb. I forgot. Forgot that I have this charge. Three more knowledge. Four from here and four from here. Puts me at 14, but I don't have any ore. And I need to build trading posts. It would be really nice to have a temple right now. Okay, so I have six power to do some stuff with that I charged. What do I do with this? Two ore? That's still not gonna get me a temple. But it does look like the ore might be the things that I need right now. Am I able to build on places? I'm not in range here unless I get this tile that I don't have. Probably takes a tile. Middle tile. Yeah, so where could I build? Here. I could certainly build here. I do not have a large number of buildings. I'm probably just not going to do it right now. Probably do it later. Trying to expand the economy as much as possible, but I'm still interested in building trading posts. I can do one this turn. And if I get enough for a temple, so I won't have to keep this trading post, get the temple. I don't want to do the temple. This would be fucking amazing, but this might be the play. We also need to get up here. Going up this doesn't enormously help right away. Get away with it. Maybe that's unwise. It's my turn first. Let's do in this order so we can get points for dropping our Gaia guy. How many points? 4? Two from the... If I have to burn a power, I can do that. I could also get these two workers, something that I am likely to need to do. I also need to go up navigation, or we could go up this track and try and build everything with cubes, which isn't the worst idea in the world. I probably still want to go up this track. Five. One, two, three, four, five. You're getting into dangerous territory, dude. Drop some mine. 3 with the tiebreaker. The most important thing is for it to be close to me. Range 3. Can't get right next to me. The next tiebreaker is final scoring. This won't matter. Oh, planet types. It does not refer to planet types. So it's just direction, this direction. This is actually first. This is actually illegal. Direction, it wasn't, this is where it was going to go anyway. So 3 for 2. But first of all, I'll let him give me more power potentially, and build this temple. I swear I know how to play this game. More power? Nope. 2 from the right. Okay, so now I do have to take the workers. Now he's going to give me power. Nope. He probably didn't get his 2 points from doing that. Or 1 point from doing this. I don't know. I think he did get the 1 point from doing that. I think. And 1 point from this. Yeah, he's gonna get this tile. Too bad. Now he upgrades, of course. Not that it matters in any way. This direction. This is the closest. Well, it does matter, I guess, because of the... Now it's charging 3, but I'm not accepting. Because... These are converting into 2 money, and then Gaia forming. He's not passing, he's doing this. I think there's 1 point for that. And he takes 2 points for going up a random track, 2 from the left. Hooray, he took it. That's all I have to do. Probably want this. This is going to cause me to waste 1 charge. But having the 3 range is of use. Passes. And it takes this. You're welcome to that one. I didn't actually randomize this. What is it? This is gold. Yeah, this was just left there because the game doesn't randomize this particular token. So I just left it. It randomizes almost everything else. It doesn't do the board randomization correctly, but it does try and randomize it. Somehow he gets 3 points from this instead of 4. He's not really in exceptional shape. And I'm first. These are probably in the wrong order. Maybe they weren't. Waste 1 charge. 4 money. Wow. 3 plus 4, right? 7 knowledge. And 6 charge points. I don't want to do this turn. We are supposed to build mines. I'm doing that at least twice. 2 points for every mine, and then this. It might be useful to have one of these. Could build maybe here. We spend some effort going up this track. That seems pretty reasonable. Then next is building on that again, worth more points if he doesn't decide to do it, which he could very easily build there. I'm going to have plenty of opportunities to build on these, even if I don't do this right away. How many planet types is he on? He's on 1, 2, 3. That's a little weird. I'm not sure if I'm going to be able to compete with him or not. I'm actually also on 3. No, I'm not. I'm on 2 because I'm not. I don't pay for terraforming. Who pays for terraforming? But yeah, this is a bad type to get to. I'll have to use cubes in order to get to types that are more manageable. But, I mean, there's a reason to try and do that. It's not like there's not. I'm gonna take this cube. Actually, we could try and build this academy and get cubes that way. Goes up his top track. He scores a point. No reason to sit on this. Actually, the other one for federations later. I wish. The primary purpose of this at this point is to get this tile to charge. this actual bonus of going up this track is kind of incidental, although maybe I'll just try and go up this track instead of doing navs, because maybe it'll work out. Maybe I'll get some things out of doing that. Alright, he gets 2 points. He goes 2 from the left. That could have potentially been bad, again. This is why I took the thing that was really important early on. Although there's another one that's kind of maybe important, taking the money, because I don't have a lot of money to do stuff this turn. Which is okay, right? The only thing I need to do this turn is spam some mines, but... it would be nice to have more money to do that more than twice. Once here and once here, and then... I would also need workers. Here's a cube, so I don't actually have this cube. I just got it from the tech. And here's another cube that I'm going to be able to get. And I have this range action to get here. So these are the two things I know I'm building. This obviously has this tile under it. I want to do this right away. Is it my turn? I didn't make him build a mine yet. Within 3 range, and he wants to build closest to me. Here, or here, but this is his best terraforming. Or these. This is also equally good terraforming. So the direction is here. This is the first one. This is a good terraforming for him. Do I want this power? Yes. If I need to burn some stuff, I can. Although it would be nice if he would just charge all of it for me. All of it. Looks like he's going to. He upgrades it to a trading post. This direction. Actually, he can get closer to me, so he will. That's a 3 for 2. I do think I was there. I really, really want the power right now, so I'm happy to pay 2 points. And I have these to go up. Might be able to get up past something. One of these two. Probably here. Can still charge me power. Two points. 4 range, and he wants to build on a new planet type. Pretty sure that's a real tiebreaker that he cares about. Yeah. So he wants to build on a new planet type, a different planet type that is the least far away from him as what he can build. He doesn't have this yet. Gray is also... I'm not next to gray. So he's going to prefer this. Which gives me more power to take. Loses me more points. Which is maybe a little awkward, but... What can I do with this other than this? I have 4 more, and potentially even more than that. But I think it's time for me to spend this. Might be time for me to burn a power. I don't need to do it yet. I don't need to burn yet. I could probably burn a power. Left in the deck. He's going to take this again. He gets 2 points. He builds as close to me as possible. This is as close to me as possible. He likes this terrain type. And that's free. Well, I'll take it if it's free, I guess. I could probably do this somewhere. I don't know where. That's just straight up 2. Maybe I could just do it here instead. Get on a new planet type. Get over towards some stuff I don't have. Maybe get to here eventually. I think I like this better. You are allowed to do this. He builds a mine. How industrious of him. 2 range. And he doesn't care about planet types right now. So he's going to build a mine on the nicest planet possible, which is this, or this, or this, or this. This is actually easier for him. Before I do that, I need to actually spend a cube. I Let's have built there instead then. From the right. And he's a whore for points. Looks like he's probably going to pass before me. He does it now. 6 points. So I think we'll just stick with this plan. Huh. Okay. Don't need to go up the economy track at all. But if I split my stuff up and go here and here, and save this 3 points till save the 3 charge until next turn, I could make more use of it. I want both of these. Let's just save that stuff until next turn entirely. He passes, taking the first. I want this again. I don't need 4 charge. Well, no, 4 money is going to be probably useful for me because I don't really have a source of money income. Now he's first. Because I have a really long turn. 4. Nothing from this anywhere else. 4 more from these are my only sources of money income. 4 from there. And I got 6 charge worth of bonuses again. Okay, to pick my bonuses. It looks still like this is the most useful thing. So he goes first. Stupid hex grid. Now his highest tech is this for 1 point. Let's get going with this. I don't know if there's anything particularly urgent that I need from here. This turn we have to build on Gaia's. Maybe I should get started doing that. So he doesn't. Well, he's not gonna steal these. Two range. He wants to build on a new planet type. He doesn't have this. Here it is again. It's one of these two. That's what he can reach. This direction, so he's gonna go here. That's a free power. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, ten. I have one, two, three, four, five, six, seven. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, plus this, which is going to be an eighth. So he's beating me on the total number of planets, and he's on how many planet types? One, two, three, four, five, six, and seven. Yeah. And he's going to pick up the lost planet. I don't think he actually places the lost planet or gets a benefit from having the planet type. Yeah, he doesn't actually get the lost planet, which is interesting. Be fucking awesome to have this. Maybe I did not. Maybe I did that last turn. Maybe. Did that last turn. Here's 3 points. Building this mine. Maybe he did. I think actually he did. Four range this time. He just wants to build the easiest planet. This is easy. So is this. This one's closer to me. Probably gonna be charge free. Which is crazy. Most urgently, workers. I mean, I don't think so because I want to be spamming a lot of. Maybe he did get checked, I don't know. Dangerous. Upgrade. this direction. You can't upgrade one distance from me, so it upgrades here. I'll just decline that power because I'll be Gaia forming later. This is only one distance and it's a new planet type. I'd like to get like these though. This will cost me a cube for range. Just did this. Next turn I have a bonus for going up tracks. Here, here, and then here. Or here, it doesn't matter. And then am I done? I might be able to build one more after that. 3 steps. That's tough. Pay this cost. That actually doesn't give me any points. I didn't take points for this. I think I got 2 points. Like, two but 5 planets ahead of the time. Oh, it's important. Helps define my turn. It's not earth shattering. 3 points. I didn't do this turn yet, did I? I'm pretty sure I was there on the board. Yeah. So I need cubes. Oh no, I can't get to this. How dumb am I for not taking this power so I could have spammed more? I don't know. I don't know what the hell's going on. I mean, another cube, maybe I'll be fine. yeah, let's get that cube. If I'm wrong and I cheated to get another cube, then I don't know. Then I'm wrong. Faction. Let me pick another one of these. Which is the first one. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. These are like gone. Do I wanna like do this? Get more cubes. Get 3 of my cubes back, and a worker, and get 3 power. Probably not super helpful. I can pick up a few from this Federation, though. Probably should do something like that. Cube to build here, which is worth 7 points. He could pass, he doesn't, he takes the faction action again, dirty bastard. I don't think I give him 2 points. Oh, he was supposed to build last time too. Range 3 and as close to me as possible. That's as close to me as possible. He's gonna do it again, but this time he can't build, so he's taking an upgrade action, right? That's what happens when you actually can't build. Let's take an upgrade action instead. Wait a minute. Because the condition is not met. Okay. Condition is not met. So he takes an upgrade action and he has to upgrade into this. Because there's literally nothing else to upgrade. And it has to be as close as possible. And in that direction. That's here. But I decline. This is a good time to do this. He just took my spot. Luckily I can go here. He could pass. He doesn't. He takes 2 points. It goes up the soundtrack. This one. Oh, gee, wow. Well. Okay. Two cubes, one for range and one for actual form. 7 points. And he does this again. 5 from the left. But doesn't get any points this time. Yeah. Okay, third federation. 3 federations out of this. Looks feasible. Let's build that one to try and do that. Nothing else happens. This can become one worker. I'd like it to be one worker. Unless I'd like this to be one worker, but I think that these are more valuable. I want to keep these. There's not really another way that I'm going to do anything else this turn, so. So 7 more points. This piece of trash. Is the one knowledge going to be useful? Is your knowledge, 4 knowledge? Yeah. Wait a minute. I need another range to get here. So here's a federation. Okay, let's just create this federation before passing. Take this. That would just let me build there. Otherwise, I could take 2 workers and build here and then here, but I don't have enough gold for it. And I don't need this planet type anyway, so I want to do this. Oh, I need range, I need a worker. And I need this thing. So I don't have enough workers. two, three, four, five, six, seven. So these are both useful. There are probably more ways to find one knowledge. This is actually one knowledge. He passed first again. Two charge got wasted. Okay, it's his turn. He takes which action? He takes this. Get this thing. Oh, I didn't do the... Oh, I'm just bad. I'm such a bad player. I forgot that this tile gave me points. Not just now. It might be worthwhile to get it now. He should get 2 points from the last turn. Scoring. Yeah, it looks like it will be useful to get it now. Looks like I'm gonna jump up here. Two, three, four, five, six. Probably should just charge this power first. Yeah, that doesn't do anything yet. He doesn't have a mine. He's just got 3 points for that. I'm not gonna get 3 points for this. Maybe he did get 3 points for that, I don't know. Maybe I should be better at figuring out. He's gonna upgrade to this thing. Actually, is he gonna upgrade to the... What's the upgrade priority? Is he upgrade for a academy first, or the trading post first? Trading post is first. That's what I thought. as close to me as possible. That's here. That's 2 for 1. Okay, fine. now I have this piece to play here. Now with round scoring, it's still a 3 point. He's got a mine now. Within 4 range, and he doesn't care about planet types. Thank God. I think he's got all the planet types. Does he not have the planet type? He doesn't have any orange? Okay. So I might actually be able to beat him, potentially. Although, he likes being here, but he likes being here more. Or here. This is closer to me. Or here. This is closer to me. Oh, he also doesn't have this planet type. That's free power. Free power is nice. I'll take free power. Maybe I made the wrong decision. Let me just do this. Looks like I need money anyway. This is where the power should be. He upgrades again. Now he upgrades into this. Now I want to decline, obviously. Oh, it's free. Never mind. And takes 4. Okay. 4 from the right, which is 1 terraform once. That's fine. And he takes 2 points. I think I gave him the 1 point for that. Okay, now I need to take some of these. Looks like 7 money might be useful. Because I just want to be upgrading stuff, and I do really want to get, I want to get these federations in. So this can already be a federation right now. It costs 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 tokens. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, yeah, there's no way around that. So I should spend some tokens first. These would also just allow me to get, like, 5 knowledge of spending these, and then a temple. This needs to upgrade one thing in order to get to, so I need to have 2 workers and 3 coins, and I need to have, well, I want to build maybe on planet types. Alright, how many planet types is he on? He's on 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 1, 2, 3, he's on brown, he's on yellow, he's on gray, he's on green, brown, yellow, gray, green, and white. He's on 5, and red, 6. Now I'm on 1, 2, 3, 4, and they were easy planet types. Tie him, but this is going to be costly in terms of my ability to get other stuff done this turn. Although I have this power, so if I just exchange this power for these resources instead of these knowledge, one of the knowledge is a good idea. Actually, 9 plus 7 is 16, so that's a perfect match. So I probably want to do the resources. I can compete with him. Maybe beat him on the planet types. Number of buildings. He's doing good on number of buildings. I may not be able to catch up with him. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. I didn't count this one. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. Well, 13, 14. Getting on some new planet flights. Like this, which is two away. And what's the other thing that's two away? It's rock. Like this. We can certainly do that. At least once, and then work this for the second one. So that means I need to be up here. Actually, the most critical thing is to get here in the first place. That's the most critical one. Upgrades for 1 point. I don't think it was 2 points last time. I feel like he's maybe gotten some cheat. Yeah, I think he did. Upgrade as close to me as possible. What can you upgrade? He wants to does he have one of those to upgrade? He does not, so he's going to upgrade this. As close to me as possible. That's here, here, here. As possibilities. This one. And how do I want that?
Are you recording?
Yes. Maybe.
How much longer are you doing this?
I'm close to finished. I'm on the last turn.
It's 3 a.m. I'm sending the kids to bed right now.
Yeah. I sent them to bed 2 hours ago,
okay,
but they
they're
didn't.
In my room watching
they.
We're watching some educational videos.
Okay.
I
Yeah, isn't it?
Yeah.
There's still things that aren't tidy though. Alright. This is a Federation. So that I can charge power first.
Yeah.
charge power. Man, this sucks. What do I need? I need this, maybe. Another faction action. He gets to upgrade as close as possible. Faster action. There. That's free. Take free. Now. Now I guess I'm taking money. I should probably have given up on these objectives. Let's say that I don't take this money, and I didn't take those workers. Well, I get 2 points for jumping up this knowledge track, and I just give up. Probably in both cases. I need to figure out if I'm actually going to be able to compete, so... I don't necessarily need the tactile. Let's say forget the tactile. It's only worth like 6 or 7 points or whatever. Alright, so I don't, not building a temple, it's not part of the plan at all, but what is part of the plan is building these buildings, and I need to build one of these in order to do that. That's 2 workers, 3 coins, then 1 worker and 2 more coins to get to here, and then right here. Now for that I'm going to actually need to spend two workers for terraforming, and then 1 worker and then coins. So that's going to get me to tie him on these categories. And another planetite would be nice, but that's 3, and I'm probably not going to have the workers for that, but maybe it's possible. Alright, so I'm doing the right thing here. Coins. Did I already take these 7 coins? Looks like I think I did, because I didn't have very many coins. Alright. I had to check that, because I wasn't sure if that was really the right play. Okay, so that was my play to get power action. First play is to... Shit, I need to take... Alright. I'm gonna take him to 2 Knowledge Federation. Destroyed. 3 points just to upgrade your buildings. I wish I got 3 points every time I upgrade my buildings. I'm declining the power at this point. I can't even do anything. So I need to do this. Close up a random track. 2 points. Now, I need to do this again. I fucking forgot. Okay, there's only I'm only gonna be able to do this twice. But here, cubed for range and 5 power. And pay the cost of a mine. That will unfortunately not help them score. Okay. Now I have a problem. I need probably more workers. Because I need to build this. Doesn't matter where anyway. Passes. He gets 4 points. Terrible, terrible Automa luck on the point values on these bonus tiles. The Automa usually get a lot more points than that. He got like 2 points and 4 points. This one was reasonable. No, this one was. What does this one say? 6 points, yeah, that's fine. And then he got zeros on some of these, which happens sometimes, but not usually not every single time. Three, I mean, that's whatever. This is fine. This is fine. This is awful. This is 4. Could have been done more favorably in the Automa's benefit. Okay. In order to even build this, I need to have more. First of all, I need to be here. Oh, I am here. but I need to have a Federation tile for this. That's all I'm going to be able to build. So I think I tied him on both of these categories. Maybe he built on another planet. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14. And I think I've also got 14. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And there's 4 buildings on this board. I have 3 buildings on my board. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14. What am I missing? Okay, why does he have more buildings left in his board than I do? board holds 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 18 buildings. Alright, what is the building that's missing? There should be 8 mines on the board. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. There should be 4 trading posts on the board. 1, 2, 3, 4. There should be 1 temple on the board. Here there should be 1 academy on the board and 1 TM. Two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15. Okay, I am miscounting. I'm not sure what's wrong with me. Yeah. Alright, so planet types. 1. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. My home type, Gaia's. The ones that are 2 away from me, these 2. White and red, so that's 4, and the ones that are 3 away, 2 away from me, 5, 6 planet types. He has 1, 2, brown, he has Gaia, he has yellow, he has the other one that's close to him, which is gray. He has brown, he has Gaia, he has yellow, he has gray, he does not have orange. He has red. Is that it? And he has white. He has a planet type that's 3 away from him as well. No, that's not 2. That's not 3 away from him. The red is 3 away from him. But he does not have this, and he does not have this. So he's tied with me on planet types. So that means I'm going to win the game for sure. Easily. I got another cube. And go up to 10. That flips a cube. Maybe it isn't. But 3 more cubes. maybe I could take both of these. I can use these 3 to rescore this fed. And then go twice. Let's do this. That's only 6. Probably took 8. I think I did take 8. But I get 6 more. And 2 more knowledge. I also went up a track. Only this once. There's some in litter boxes. I don't... Yeah. Now I have two advances. I can get these two and then get a third advance. Actually, just one of these gets me a third advance, so... And then all these cubes disappear to take this action. What's good? Well, here's 7 points, or here's 7 points, but this one is going to get me points for walking up the track. A tactile. Yeah, that's more points than the other one. This to get these two, and then I have this left to go up here. Move! You take this. Picking a tile. 7 points and 6 money. Well, looks like I can get another tech tile. How many did I just go up? I went up 1, 2, 3. And I can get another tech tile. I can walk up here and do something else with this, maybe. But these are all taken. I could take this. This is worth 3 points, and then I can go up here. If I just take this, then I have to go up this one. That's 7 points. Maybe I can build that type and beat him out. I actually think that I should be able to do this. So let's go ahead and take this tile. And walk up here. All of which I can do. Because I have these tiles to flip. Pay for the temple that I just built. Oh, I don't have a mine. Yeah, I forgot about that part. But you know what I can do? I can build another temple. Ridiculous. This last turn worked out rather well. For me,
I was able to do a lot of things in my last turn, and I'm commenting that mostly to the camera, but
I mean there's a lot of things I didn't do on the last turn, but I pretty, like, objectively I got a lot done, and I got these four federations. That's pretty unusual to get four of these, although one of them is just this. Yeah, Terrans are pretty good, just in a general map. Like, this map wasn't especially favorable to Terrans, although it was pretty good. I went up here, that's another 2 points, and then I'm taking this one, having to go here, that's 2 points, and then 7 points for the actual tile. Alright. So, this is 8 points. By the way, we haven't done final scoring yet. And I won those categories. This is 3 points. This is how many? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So 3 points and then 6 points. That's all before final scoring. That's just from this ship. And all of these federations and stuff. Now we do final scoring. Most planet types. So we've tied, and we got we got more than this guy. So both of us get 15 points. He's gonna have 107, and I'm gonna have 41. In this one, I beat him, and he has more than 11. So he gets 12 points. I get 18 points. Tex. I don't have resources, do I? No, I spent them all. But Tex. 36 points. Okay, that's a good score. He has 24 points. Okay, so in this case, I actually would have beaten the Alptrauma, the highest difficulty level of the Automa. He got really unlucky, and I got fabulously lucky. And I'm playing Terrans, not the most busted faction necessarily, but they worked out very well. Did I cheat? I hope not. Would it have mattered? I hope not. Here's your final score, 195. This is a very, very good score. This might be my highest score in any game ever. I've definitely gotten like to between 170 and 180, maybe higher than 180 before. This is a weak score for the Automa. And if he were on Alptrauma, he would have gotten points every time he scored points. So he has 13 cards in his deck, which he's supposed to have on the first turn he would get. I don't know, it depends on how many, but he starts with like 8 cards in his deck, and probably gets 6 points, and then 7 points, and then 8 points. So he's getting like 8.5 times 6, which is like maybe about 50 points. But I'm beating him if he gets another 50 points. Literally, if you add 50 points to his score, I'm still beating him. It's really close. Like, he's really close to winning in this condition. I don't know if I've ever had if I had been playing against Alptrauma, I would have won this game. And I don't know if that's ever been true before. That's why I don't play against it, but maybe I should. I don't know. You can just lose most of the time. And occasionally do amazing things like this. And wonder if maybe I made a mistake and cheated on an occasion or two. And maybe I made a mistake and cheated in the AI's favor as well. Who knows? Yeah, so there you have it. Terrans 195, Taklons 144. That's crazy. There are a lot of things this game that worked out really well for me. The bonus tiles didn't give him very many points. Would this give him points too when he passes? I don't know if Alptrauma gets points when he passes. That might actually. That might make the game different. That might make a difference. So maybe the Alptrauma is just not beatable. I guess he would. The only thing it says is that during final scoring, he doesn't gain extra points. But during these round scorings, he would gain extra points, I believe, because it says every time, except during final scoring, he gains one extra point whenever he gains points. What else happened? I mean, he let me pick all of the, like, really essential power actions that I needed, which may not happen all the time, like in the last game when that didn't happen. He, he let me get on these planets that I needed to get on, and he didn't manage to actually, despite having, like, I mean, he did a good job getting his planets out, or getting his buildings out, right? He lost on buildings after having 14 buildings. A human player isn't necessarily going to do that, even if they play really well. So I mean, can I criticize him that hard for tying me on the most planet? I mean, tying me for most planet types? Okay, tying is not bad. And if he, if the Lost Planet counted, he would have taken that too. Against the Ultoma and not the Ultrauma, that wouldn't have mattered at all. I mean, he wins the planet types, but he still loses by a very large margin. And just like, I had room to maneuver and do everything I needed to do, and some of the numbers worked out really well in the last couple of turns. I mean, obviously, the picking up the bunch of planets worth 7 to colonize a Gaia planet on the last turn. I mean, there's some opportunity costs there, right? You have to actually take this tile, which tile is it? This one, to get more points when you're, whenever you build Gaia planets in order to pull off that combo. And that comes at an opportunity cost of not getting something with income on it, or something that could, like, I mean, okay, sure, the charge four power is not, doesn't have income on it, but, like, that helps your economy. So, did he pass more off? Like, he didn't necessarily, like, he didn't pass more often than normal. Like, sometimes he didn't pass until he ran out of cards, and then sometimes he passed the first time, and then sometimes he passed the second time, which is how it's supposed to go. Last game, actually, I didn't play as well as this, and the Automa just passed early a lot. I don't know if he passed early all 6 turns, but he passed early a lot. And he took these tech tiles that I was targeting. Like, let's say that he just had gone up these other tracks instead, and I got those tech tiles. Like, let's say he went, I don't know, the tech tiles were in the right places. This would have been so many more points for me to get these useful tiles instead of the tiles I actually got. I'm not in this sector. I'm in the other 6 sectors. So here's 12 points, and here's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 16 points. Yeah, I'd like to have 16 points plus 12 points is 28 points instead of 9 points. 28 is greater than 9. I like winning. Yeah, so I mean, how hard can you criticize luck for the Automa? For he got 14 buildings out and got beaten, and then he got 6 planet types and tied. He didn't even lose the category, he tied and beat his stupid benchmark. He got 6. I'm inclined to say the Automa didn't play a bad game. Maybe I got really lucky. The Automa got unlucky in this respect. Definitely with these bonus tiles. The Automa got very unlucky in the terms of the amount of points he scored. But against the difficulty level of Automa that I played, right, against the Automa, that does not matter. This he's not going to beat this score. He's not going to come close. Even if a bunch of things went his way, he might be in this range. This is a ridiculous score. Very, very seldom to get to this score in any kind of game, playing 4 players against other. You can do this if you play against 4 players and other players, and they have no idea what they're doing and don't take your advice, and they just give you power whenever it's convenient for you to get power exactly. But this score is not easy to hit. All right, that's Gaia Project. Have a terrible day.